Hello, Bill from Vanaman here to talk about setup and maintenance of our mobile ProBlast. Once you get it out of the box, you can uncurl the foot pedal and the handpiece. You're going to have to connect it to your air supply. We have a handy blog post on different connections. Be sure to check that link. I'm using a 1/4-inch outer diameter urethane tubing connection. It fits right into the quick disconnect that comes already installed on the Master Mobile ProBlast. The barb connection is already installed on the standard Mobile ProBlast, and both variants come with both types of connections. Make sure your air supply is off before you connect it, and you need to keep it off when you remove the tank lid to fill up with your blasting media. With the Master Mobile ProBlast, which we see here, you need to make sure the switch is in the off position. A quick note about air compressors, the minimum requirements are 90 PSI at 1.5 CFM. We recommend 2.5 CFM or better. And of course, how big it needs to be depends on how you're going to use it. This is our compressor, but not everybody has room for this kind of industrial tank. A 5 or 6 gallon tank is plenty for some users, not nearly enough for others. You should keep an eye on the pressure gauge on your blaster. If you see it running down while you're blasting, it may be that your air compressor is just running out of compressed air and can't keep up. When you put your media into the tank, make sure to keep a fingertip over the top of the manifold tube. If you get media in there, it's not a huge problem, but once you start blasting, it'll take a moment or two before the air in the media mix balances out. The more media you pour in the top of the manifold tube, the longer it'll take. While the lid is off, make sure there's no dust on the O-ring. Also, it's a good idea to brush out the grooves on the tank and lid to ensure there's no media or dust on them, because worn out threads can cause damage over time, including leaks, and you need a completely sealed system to function properly. It may also lead to the lid getting locked on, and you don't want that. You also want to make sure that the O-ring is secure when you put it back in. A loose O-ring can be very problematic indeed. Make sure to screw on the lid nice and tight, but not too tight. Once your media is in the tank and your air supply is connected, you're ready to begin blasting. For the standard blaster, if your air supply is on, you'll see the PSI setting on your gauge. With the Master Mobile ProBlast, you need to flip the switch to the on position, and then you'll see the pressure on the gauge. 60 PSI is the factory setting, and that's a great place to start, but you can adjust it to where you want. The more you experiment, the better idea you'll get for where your ideal PSI is. To adjust the PSI, pull up on the knob on top of the regulator and twist. You can go higher or lower as you see fit. To start blasting, step on that foot pedal and off you go. Blaster maintenance is very important, so here's what you need to know to keep your unit operating as it should. First, just look at the tip. The nature of sandblasting is destructive. Over time, all that media going through your tip is going to wear it down, so you're going to need to replace it. We have a video on assembling the handpiece, which includes a bit on the tip, so be sure to check that video out. For the Master Mobile ProBlast, please make sure that the switch is in the off position when you're not using it. You don't want to keep it pressurized when it's not in use, because that creates strain on the tubing. You'll also want to make sure that you regularly move the tubing through the pinch valve. The valve inside this casing is one of the greatest points of wear on the tubing, so make sure it isn't always pinching the same spot. Move it around to keep your tubing in good shape. Now, if you get a clog in the blaster, that's going to create a lot of performance issues. So one of the most important things you need to do is keep your media dry. Store it in a safe, dry place, and preferably in an airtight container. If you get any moisture in there, that can lead to clumping, and clumping can lead to blockage, which of course leads to performance issues. Moisture is the enemy. Keep your media dry. If there's moisture in your air supply, that can get into the tank and again cause clumping. You'll see clumping first around the air inlet in the bottom of the tank, or you might see clumping in the holes at the bottom of the manifold tube. If that happens, first you should correct the issue at the source, whether with the air supply or with the media from storage, and then you'll want to get a toothbrush and brush those areas clear of those clumps and get it out of your tank. Once it's clear, it's helpful to put the lid back on and blow some dry compressed air all the way through your blaster before refilling with more media. If there's a clog in the handpiece, you can take it apart very easily to clean it. Again, see our other video on handpiece assembly for how to do that. If you're getting leakage issues, the O-rings may be the culprit here. Remember, the O-ring in the lid needs to be securely in its place. And again, make sure there's no dust or debris in the threads. Brush that stuff out. Make sure the O-ring in the handpiece is in good shape and is flush with the tip. Remember, this is not like playing ring toss. And lastly, double check those O-rings down at the bottom of the tank. Remember, your tubes need to be pushed in past the O-rings. You should also make sure there's no dust or debris in the inserts themselves. That can cause leakage issues as well. While you're blasting, please also note the system works best when there's more sand in the tank. You'll notice a drop in efficiency while you're blasting if there is less media in the tank. As always, reach out to Vanaman with any questions you have. You can reach us by phone at 760-723-1498 or email us at service@vanaman.com.